for years, Wi-Fi repairs on iPhone 12 or later models were impossible for independent repair shops due to Apple's part pairing system. But now, a groundbreaking solution has been found. This is the first time we've made such a huge breakthrough of iPhone repairs since the release of iPhone 12. In this video, we'll show you how Wi-Fi repairs on an iPhone 13 are done. Disassemble the iPhone 13. Cover the cameras with protection stickers. Remove the motherboard and split it. Test the circuits related to the Wi-Fi module to verify that they are normal. Since the Wi-Fi serial number cannot be obtained simply by connecting the iPhone to the programming software, we will remove the non-chip and read the Wi-Fi serial number from there. Heat the non-chip evenly with a hot air gun at 420 degrees Celsius and airflow 80, and then pry the non-chip up. Apply some flux to the soldering pad of the non-chip. Remove the tins from soldering pad, using braid and a soldering iron. Place the non-chip in a Lube-On programmer. Connect the programmer to a PC, and open the programming software. Click Check Factory Data to read the ECID of the iPhone. Read the ECID from the non-chip. Place a new Wi-Fi module into the Lube-On programmer to write in the Wi-Fi serial number. Copy the ECID and select Wi-Fi operations on the navigation menu. Paste the ECID and click Check Now. Then click Write Now. The Wi-Fi serial number has been written into the new Wi-Fi module. Next, we will replace the Wi-Fi module. Place the signal board onto a fixture. Cover some other components with Captain Tape for protection. Heat the Wi-Fi module with hot air gun, and use a pry knife to remove the edge adhesives. Pry up the Wi-Fi module. Apply some flux to the soldering pad of the Wi-Fi module. Remove the tins from the soldering pad, using braid and a soldering iron. Remove the tins from the soldering joints of the signal board. Remove the tins from the soldering joints of the logic board. Align the new Wi-Fi module carrying the serial number to the soldering pad. Solder the new Wi-Fi module with hot air gun at 380 degrees Celsius and airflow 60. Solder the non-chip with hot air gun at 380 degrees Celsius and airflow 60. Put the logic board and the signal board into a motherboard layered test fixture. Connect the iPhone 13 screen cable and the power cable. Use a pair of tweezers to trigger the power on. The iPhone 13 is powered on properly. Go to settings. The Wi-Fi function toggle is resumed. Solder the signal board with the logic board. Assemble the iPhone 13 and test the Wi-Fi function. Wi-Fi is restored, and it connects properly. Thank you for watching.